right now for you to find greatness in yourself. You're not going to find it by looking in a book or by even hearing me. I may give you the spark, but you've got to go inside yourself to find it. And that means you got to be quiet. Shut the fuck up. Go in a room. Stop talking. Search your soul. Search your mind. Search your abilities. And you'll find it. But if you're not looking for it, you won't find it. So you got to go start your journey. And the journey starts with you finding, why the hell am I here on this planet Earth? Why am I here? Self-doubt, insecurities, fucking imperfections, jealousy, all these fucking things, allow people to bully you, fuck you around, your nuts start to retract back up. Insecurities end up here, self-doubt, all this shit, you freaking up in your fucking chest, end up with chestnut syndrome. How you fix chestnut syndrome is you gotta man the fuck up, hit your fucking chest, send a signal to your fucking mind that you're gonna man the fuck up, and then fall back in your fucking sack. Once they fall back in your sack, you sack it the fuck up. Stay hard.
For everything I went through in my life, every bad fucking thing I went through in my life, the two heart surgeries, all the name calling, being everything I went through, if you learn how to flip that motherfucker on top of his head and say, hang on, there's so much power in this fucking thing. If you look at life as it is a trial ground, a testing ground, for where you need to belong, where you need to go. Suffering is a fact of life. It is a great tool to callous your mind. If you look at it as suffering, woe is me, this is bullshit, God, kicking rocks. If you look at it like, okay, motherfucker, you're testing me now. I get it. Whenever I'm being like depressed, I go through depressed moments, okay, oh, hang on. I'm getting tested. So you have to be aware of all the signals and signs that are being given to you from the world.
We idolize so many people, and we want to be them. We want to be someone else. And in doing that, you lose all the potential of who you are. You mimic. You be them. You are them. You become them. And you lose you. And we looked up to so many people in this world who would let us down. They're humans. I'm going to let you down. You're going to let somebody down. And you put on a pedestal, you then lose time when that person comes up and lets you down. You must hold yourself accountable and being your hero, that's what that does. You make yourself so totally accountable for who you are. You focus on you and only on you to become the best person you can be for others.
This is when I realized I was alone on this earth. I have God alone on this earth, and I have to fix everything. And this is where I started to develop an indestructible mental toolbox.
Okay. Life's about self-discipline. It is about self-discipline. We tend to do the things that are easy. And that is, it builds no mental toughness. It builds no mental hardening. It builds nothing. Working out is where you can build that the fastest. because it's a constant, it gives you instant feedback. The discipline it takes, it transfers over to all aspects of your life. It's not people, man, why are you always working out? Stop looking at it that way. This is the foundation of life. The first thing you see is your reflection. If you don't like what you see in the morning, you lost the war already. You have to control that reflection in the mirror. That's how you start your day. Leave your house feeling like, okay, I can fight. I've established the mentality to fight. And that all that comes from working out. It's not just from, you know, you can't find that in all.
Remember how you had a job interview for a job? We've had several of them in our lives. What did you do the night before that job, weeks before the job interview? You knew you had it. You prepared your, you know, you had a bowl out for your oatmeal, your cereal, whatever you had in the morning time. Your coffee cup was out. Your clothes were laid out. You were studied. You rehearsed. You were ready. You brought your best self. You were going to war with yourself because you wanted that interviewer to see your best self. You won. You got the job. After a few months in that job, you look around. I got the job. Start to back off. The clothes aren't out. You're not ready. Hitting the snooze button. You don't get up on time anymore. You realize that you can still have this job and not be your best self. The interview you is gone. Your job is gone. You have your job, but the interview you is gone. So winning the battle in the morning time is just that. It's that you wake up in the morning time and you own all this stuff. Because once you leave your house, the world then gets at you. And that's why I believe in not getting up in the morning time and checking your phone immediately. Everybody does that. They get up, the first thing they do is grab their phone. Look at the phone. Maybe bad news on there. So how's your day start off? I don't go to the gym. I don't make my bed. You're caught up now on that phone. That's how your day starts. You lost control.
And people may listen to this and say, this guy is sadistic, he's crazy, No, if you know how I came up, you realize I was just a scared kid that found drive and passion to do something much better than what he thought he was. That's all it is.